Hello friends, welcome to the channel, Electrical Deck. In this video, we are going to learn about construction, working principle, advantages, and applications of shaded pole induction motor. Let us start the video. At first, what is an shaded pole induction motor? There are different types of induction motors are available, that is, three-phase, as well as single-phase. Single-phase induction motors are widely used in modern days. As we know, single-phase machine cannot produce rotating magnetic field, hence, requires auxiliary winding for producing phase shifts between fields. The auxiliary winding here used is single-turn winding, called as shading coil. Shaded pole induction motor is a single-phase induction motor which can run without the capacitor. That is why it is called capacitor-less single-phase induction motor. Let us see the construction of shaded pole induction motor. The construction of a shaded pole induction motor is very simple because it does not contain any commutator, brushes, collector rings, or any other parts, like DC motor. The shaded pole induction motor does not have any centrifugal switch. Thus, the chances of failure of the motor are less. Let us see the construction of stator of a shaded pole induction motor. The poles of the motor is of salient pole type. The salient pole means that the magnetic poles of the motor are projected towards the armature of the motor. The windings coils are wound around the poles and excited when supply is given to them. A part of each pole is wrapped by a copper ring. This copper ring forms a closed loop across each pole. This loop is known as the shading coil, and the area around this shading coil is known as shading part of the motor. The remaining part is known as unshaded part. The magnetic core of the motor is laminated to reduce eddy current loss. The lamination means multiple thin layers of material are used for making the core, so that the strength of the pole increases. The rotor of the motor is placed between the magnetic poles. The construction of rotor for a shaded pole induction motor normally uses the squirrel cage type rotor. The bars of the rotor is skewed at an angle of 60 degrees. The skew can be done for obtaining the better starting torque. The bars of the motor are short-circuited by an end ring, so that current can circulate through them when EMF is induced in it to produce opposite flux. The construction. Now, let us see the working principle of an shaded pole induction motor. At first, as we know that the current carried by the stator winding is alternating, and it produces an alternating flux. The distribution of this flux in the pole area is greatly influenced by shading coil of that pole. Let us assume three different instances, says T1, T2, T3, during first half cycle of the flux. Now here, let us take case 1, that is, at instant T1, among three different instants. When the supply is given to the motor at instant T1, the rate of rise of current is very high. Thus, the flux, pi m, will also very high. Due to mutual induction, large EMF is induced in the copper shading coil. as the shading coil is short-circuited. This circulates an current in the shading coil, which in turn produces its own flux, pi s. According to Lenz's law, this current will be opposite to the supply current, and hence, flux will also in opposite direction to the main pole flux, pi m. Hence, there is crowding of flux in unshaded part and weakening of flux in shaded part. Therefore, the overall magnetic axis will shift to the center of unshaded part, and the rotor will tries to align with that magnetic axis. Now, let us consider another instant D2 on the positive half cycle of the alternating flux as case 2. Here, when the supply is given at instant D2, the rate of rise of current and rate of change of flux is almost zero, because the instant D2 is the positive peak value of that cycle. Hence, at this instant, the flux pi m will be maximum and change of flux will be zero. Therefore, there is very little induced EMF in shading coil, and the flux produced by the shading coil pi s is almost negligible. So, there is no opposing flux to the main flux pi m. Therefore, the magnetic axis will lies at the center of the pole. Now, here, the rotor will tries to align with this new magnetic axis and rotates. Now, let us take one more instant. That is T3 on the same positive half cycle of the alternating flux as case 3. When the supply is given at this instant T3, the current and the flux are decreasing as seen in waveform. As the rate of decreasing is very high, again, there will be an EMF induced in the shading coil. This EMF circulates an current in the shading coil, which produces its own flux, pi s. But, in this case, the direction of shading coil flux, pi s, and the direction of main pole flux, pi m, are in same direction. Due to this, there will be an crowding of flux in shaded part as compared to non-shaded part. Therefore, the magnetic axis at this instant will be at the center of shaded part of the pole, and there will be a further rotation of rotor. The three different cases that we have seen will continue for negative half cycle also. In this way, the rotor changes its position for each instant, and there will be an production of rotating magnetic field. Let us check out the advantages and disadvantages of shaded pole induction motor. The cost of shaded pole induction motors are very cheap and reliable. The construction of shaded pole motors are simple, with rugged in nature. No centrifugal switch is needed as compared to capacitive start induction motor. But unshaded pole induction motor as the disadvantage of low efficiency. Since the shading coil is made up of copper, the copper loss is more. Also, there are many applications of shaded pole induction motor. They are used in small instruments, toys, small fans, electric clocks, hair dryers, ventilators, circulators, and much more applications. Thank you for watching. See you soon again. And don't forget to subscribe us for more electrical stuff.